Hi, my name is Mike Huber. I'm with Cogswell Polytechnical College. Today we're going to be showing you how to make a really cool lava shader in Maya using procedural materials and file materials. So let's get started. So the first thing I'm going to do here is grab a sphere, a polygon sphere. So we're going to grow that. Let's go over to the polysphere attributes here and dial this up to 60 so we get more subdivisions in here. I'm going to hit 5 so we can shade this and deselect the sphere. I kind of put it over here to the side because I'm going to have my hypergraph over in this area, and I kind of want to clear some screen space for myself. Okay, so let's turn this to high quality rendering too. So we're at default, and we're going to go over here to high quality and just activate that so we get a little better shading and lighting attributes. So let's go to the Windows rendering editors down to Hypershade. I usually just have a hotkey set for that, so I can just hit H and it gets me into Hypershade automatically. All right, so I want to use a blend material, so I'm going to grab a blend and just drag and drop that onto here. Usually when you're doing rock materials, you're going to use like a Lambert, but in the case of lava, lava has like some sheen to it. If you think of like obsidian, there's like a glassy kind of sheen to, or specular highlight on the actual lava itself. So, all right, so I'm just going to move this over here a little bit and minimize this and maximize this lower area so I can work in here. Okay, zoom out a little bit. Okay, so the first thing that I'm going to do is drop in a color attribute. So let's make sure we got all of our stuff here. We got all of our nodes, okay? So I'm going to grab this file texture. We're going to double click on here and go over to grab a file material. I'm going to go right to the desktop. Usually you're going to have your textures in a texture directory. So I went and made this kind of cool lava texture in Photoshop out of a dirt texture and then just painted over it a little bit more. So here's our really cool, like, believe it or not, this is going to be our lava material. And it's just a black and white image that I edited in Photoshop. I'm going to drop this into our color parameter. And then I'm going to go over here and hit 6 so we can see what it looks like on our actual sphere. I'm going to rotate this around, get kind of a good area that might kind of be cool when we render this out. All right, this kind of looks neat. Okay, obviously this is just a black and white image, and you know I want to give it some color parameters. So we're going to go and use a really cool effect called color remapping. Okay, so in here under effects, scroll down, we have this color remap, and we have this insert button. So I'm going to go and I'm going to do insert, and what's happened now is we have essentially remapped the color space of this material from RGB into HSV value. And just so you know how you're oriented here, I'm going to get rid of the green, and we're going to switch this out because we want to have the brighter color on top to fill in the whites, and then we want to have the darker color down here on the bottom. If you think about this ramp as in like from 0 to 255, the darker values are going to be down here at the bottom of the ramp. The lighter values that you're filling in are going to be here at the top. So let's bring this color down. So we're going to click on this little color attribute here and hit accept. And then let's make this a little more of an orangey red. Okay. So essentially now what we've done is we've mapped the dark areas to like a dark color and then the light areas to like an orange or red color. You know, I want to get some of the saturation out of here, so let's just go completely gray and bring this down. Not completely black, I don't want those areas to be black, but a grayish color, kind of a more ashy. And so now that we look at our material, this is what we got. So if we render that out quickly, you can see we've got this sphere now that has kind of some lava stuff going on, but of course we want to get it way more detailed than what we have right now. So what we're going to do now is we're going to duplicate this part of the chain here going into our shader, because we're going to reuse these instances several times to create different effects or different layers and make the shader much more realistic looking. So I'm going to go over here to Edit, Duplicate, Shading Network. Okay. And let's just orient everything so we keep our screen space clean. Okay, and I'm going to plug this in to the bump map. Okay, so now you look here under high quality rendering, and we can see that this is bumping out, and it, where the lava pits are, it's going to be sinking in, and where the rock is, it's going to be kind of jetting out. So this is going to be a little more accurate to what real lava would look like. Now, of course, I really don't need to do the remap here. I just thought I would just duplicate the entire shader network here and plug it in as a bump map. So it really doesn't matter what color this is, as long as this is a brighter color and this is a darker color down here. All right, so let's move this over a little bit. Now, if we render this out, let's check this out now. So this is getting a little closer to what we want as far as a realistic lava shader. The one thing, though, is that we want to have like a glow in between the cracks here. And also, the one thing that was kind of bothering me a little bit, of course, is that we want to have more detail here with the rock areas. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go grab a fractal procedural material, and I'm going to drop that into this area here. Now, that would be one of the benefits of doing a remap here is that now that we can plug in a ramp material to do the RGB to HSV remap, is that I can take these dark values and I can plug a whole new material into those dark values. Okay, and now as you see over here on the screen, this looks a lot bumpier in the where the rock is. So I'm going to go and I'm going to futz with this a little more. I'm going to turn the ratio up a little bit so this gets noisier. And I'm going to make this material a little darker, of course. Really, when it comes to bump maps, you want areas of high contrast. So I want some light values like in between the cracks and then some dark values where the rock is. Okay, so now if we render this out, you can see here we're kind of getting some interesting values. So if I want to tweak this any further, I think we should just move into IPR, which is our interactive rendering system. So I'm going to turn IPR on, and let's see how we do with IPR. So I have IPR on, and I'm going to select an area that I want to re-render quite a bit because I'm going to be tweaking on these areas. And as you can see, this is kind of like interactive and kind of some real-time tweaking that's going on. I'm going to select the material itself because it's a little too shiny, and I'm going to bring some of the more specular values down. So we have a little bit of a sheen there. Then also I'm going to take our fractal material that I have plugged in here, and I'm going to edit it just a little bit just to get more of the values and the bump that I want. Let's go back here and make this even more extreme as far as the bump map goes. Okay, so we're getting pretty close here. This is actually turning into kind of a more realistic material. And of course it's getting a little more complex, but you're going to have a lot of complexity in a material if you want it to be more photoreal. So let's do one more thing here. Let's grab this node, which was originally plugged into our color, and I'm going to duplicate it one more time. I'm going to bring it down here. So once again, we have our remapped color material here. And we're going to plug it into the incandescence. So now that I plug this into incandescence, you can see we get some really kind of cool things going on where we have little glows. I'm going to take this this ramp on the incandescence here, and I'm going to change some of these colors. So we get like some kind of cool oranges and just a gradation of different colors that are going into the actual lava. Okay, that's pretty cool. So let's do one more thing, because we, lava is like really hot. So we want lava to glow. So we're going to go on down here to effects for this material, and we're going to pump the glow up. Okay, let me remap here. So now you can see all of our materials plugged into the shader. Let's on the shader, we're going down here once again to special effects, and we have this glow intensity. So we're going to pump the glow intensity up here. Now, as you can see, the material is starting to glow. And what we want to do now is we don't want it to glow in these dark areas. We want it to just glow where, you know, where the lava is flowing through the cracks here, right? So we're going to go and get both of our top and bottom editors here in our hypergraph. And I'm going to click on this shader glow node. And I'm going to take my threshold on the shader glow, and I'm going to bump the threshold up. So basically, we're just getting our glow attributes to kind of come through the brighter parts of the image. All right, and let's just give this one more render. Actually, let's center it up and render this out in a high quality render. And voila, we have a really, really cool lava shader that's fully animatable, and you can do all kinds of stuff with this. And we did it in just like 5 minutes with essentially one file material and a bunch of procedural methods. Thank you.